to ride a train. Card is not working. Guys, Sakay na miss a train.
Cash is king.
Cash is king. Where you want a picture?
Oh, get a picture.
You want a picture in there?
I'll get you.
No, you go there.
Okay.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Yeah. No, it's alright. Let's go.
Good morning.
Morning. We're moving now, guys. We're moving. That's the village.
About that, the white mouse is staying again. So,
What you looking at? We arrive. This is the other station. Are we getting off here?
You put this one on my hand.
Yeah. Huh? Yeah. It is chilly. This is the train.
Not a diesel.
All diesel.
Series. There's only three of them left now, so we've tried to keep this as going quick and paint them a bit of undercover.
Yeah. They do make a nice body.
Yeah.
It's got another.
Inside, you'll see the history that we've On our Facebook recently about a rollover with a train on it. This was it. Fortunately, it wasn't much damage. Not to this anyway, but quite a bit of damage to the trailer it was on. But we were quite lucky in that respect. So it was full of graffiti. It took about a fortnight to get the graffiti off it. We stripped it out, ready to start restoration on it. And in a couple of weeks' time, we're going to get another one through and from Ipswich, and it'll be the pigeon pair then. So it'll have as much graffiti on it as well. So if anybody's got a spare moment, you know.
Where will you guys use it, on which?
Well, we're planning to run on the rail.
On this track?
Yeah, on this track here. Okay. And they're Rolls-Royce engines, so we reckon that might be the only way we get to drive a Rolls-Royce. Yeah, welcome to our workshop. This is where all the magic happens with our restorations. On a Tuesday and Thursday, this is an absolute hive of activity with all of our volunteers that come up and start doing the restorations for us. In 2015, that photo there shows you what we have here. So there was nothing here, and this is what we've come to now. So we're a fully volunteer group and non-profit. So anybody you see working here today is all volunteers. And we own the 22 kilometres of track between here and Atherton, and we're slowly restoring that. So hopefully in the next 10 years we'll be running between here and Atherton.
Okay.
So it's a good project, but we're getting there slowly. And it's all done on people like you supporting us by riding on the train and donations from the general public. So I'll let the boys take over and give you a bit more information about what we're doing here. This is William and Eamon, and they will just give you a quick rundown about what we're doing.
Hi everyone, this is our workshop. I'll start off with this train here. This is our tin liner locomotive. It is made up of two section cars, one on each end, and the two carriages in the middle are custom built by our group. We've had this train for over about 7, maybe nearly 8 years. We use this to run between here and the historic village, just like you did then, when the packet was not working and we were restoring it. Last year in November, we ran a similar thing from Platypus Park to the end of Hastings Road. One of our busiest weekends, about 100 to 200 people a day, and we hope to do that more times again this year. So,
That's an afternoon, though. That's an afternoon, because we've got 2 kilometres of track already installed down here as well. So, if you'd like to move on,
we've got the chassis of a three-cane locomotive. Specifically, it was numbered just the number 2, and it works for the Mulgrave Tribunal and Border Vale, which is a 2-foot gauge sugarcane railway. And because it's 2-foot gauge, that means their tracks were smaller than our tracks. So what we've done is we have taken it apart, and we're currently working on re-gauging the chassis to our 3-foot 6 gauge. And if you look back there, you can see the continued cab of the locomotive painted in its original paint scheme that was once in motion for the railway. These type of diesels were very common on sugarcane railways at the time. They lasted from around the 1950s all the way to the 2010s when they started the garage sales for the sugarcane railways. And many have been rebuilt into more modern variants. And here we have another sugarcane related locomotive. This one's a rather strange looking one. It's called the Pie Cart. People don't know why it's called the Pie Cart, but that's just what they're going to call it. It was supposed to be built by the mill for one specific purpose, and that was to clear the flood waters in the Gold River Valley. The Mulgrave Sugar Mill owned a branch line called the Little Mulgrave Valley, and it floods very often, and this had its bridges built at a higher clearance, so it could go into the flood waters to make sure the railway was okay. before then the other two became a
So down here is our second packet. It is almost identical to the one we just wrote on. They also shared an identical vibe to this one. This one was built in 1908 in Bristol in the United Kingdom. That one was made in the same place just 3 years earlier in 1905. It was shipped to the Mount Morgan mines in West Queensland and served there for a couple of years before moving to the Mount Isa mines, and once it finished service there, it was moved to some schoolyard around that area and used as play equipment for the students and the children. It fell into the hands of a few private collectors before going to the Downstream Tourist Railway, which we then traded, and then went into the hands of another private collector, which we traded our C-17 at Atherton for the two packets. This one is actually in better condition than that one up there, so hopefully it's quicker to restore this one than the next one. We hope it takes about 5 years maybe to fix that one, to get it fully running and fully ready to roll.
This coach here is practically identical to the one you rode on. It was a very common type of coach used throughout Queensland through the 1900s. This one was specifically built in 1913, and we hope to have it running with the other coach sometime as well. And some general history about the area. This railway came about with a need for tin mining here, which was taking place in the 1800s, and there was a demand for a railway. So they started constructing the railway from Cairns to here to Herberton, but that was a very long and gruesome process, especially building the Cairns to Karanda section. And all that hard work, and then the time it got here, all the tin had run out, which was quite unfortunate. But since then, it became a part of the larger Tableland System rail network that had many branch lines, and currently, present day, goes far west of Forsyth. But this part of the Tableland System was shut down in the late 1980s because the passenger trains were not making enough profit. And unfortunately, a lot of the other branch lines in the area closed down for that reason as well. But the direct line from Cairns to Forsyth still exists today. This would have gone as far as Ravensbury, this section of railway. That's all I really have about to say. Thank you for riding on the train, and thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please just ask me or him or Judy back there. Thank you.
Thank you.
Guys, we're in the museum of the rail train. This is the... That's before?
Yeah.
So that's the train we ride on? Look like it. Maybe sure. Similar. Look at the old telephone. Yeah. Uniform, Queensland Rail. That's the steam engine, guys.
Yeah, I think so.
Run by water. It's boiling, Jenny.
Yeah.
Stand there, Jenny. Jenny, look. Okay.
Average day. It's between 2 and 2.5 wheelbarrow full.
Oh, that's, oh, I thought you were going to say ton.
No,
that's a lot of shoveling.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. We've never really worked with it with the water.
We're going. Oh, chili. We're going back. Guys, we're done with the train. Now we're going back to
see my big diesel.
The big engine of Johnny Boy. Let's go. Let's go, Johnny Boy.